Okay, good afternoon. So in this short presentation, we'll try to understand what is H index. See, H index can be for an institute, it can be for a journal, it can be for an individual, or it can be for a country as well. Before we further go into the details that what is the H index, let me share with you my experience. Most of the people will not be knowing about what is H index, or they will be highly confused with what this number is. So that is why we thought that we must make a small video which should elaborate this basic concept. In this term H index, H basically stands behind the name of the person who gave this term, and his name is Hirsch. Hirsch index, and this term was first of all coined sometime in year 2005, when scientific community felt that there should be some kind of parameter which should be able to, using which one should be able to gauge the contribution of an individual or a country, as I told earlier, to the research output basically. So as I told, H stands for Hirsch over here. It was given sometime in 2005. Let me try to make you understand it through an example. Let us assume the H index is 5, which means, now this is somewhere where I really need your attention. If H index is 5, it means 5 research papers of that entity, where the entity can be an institute, individual author, country or journal, as I told earlier. If H index is 5, it means 5 research papers of this particular entity have been cited minimum 5 or more number of times. This is not the meaning of H index. Let us try to understand it through an example now. Say if there is an individual researcher who has got, say, 7 research papers. So I write here count of research paper, and I write here count of citations here. So research paper number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Let us assume research paper number 1 has been cited say 7 number of times. Research paper number 2 has been cited say 5 number of times. Research paper number 3 has been cited say 4 number of times. Research paper number 4 has been cited say 5 number of times. And so on. I am writing just some random numbers. And research paper number 7 has been cited say only 2 number of times. Now we need to find out the H index in this particular case. So I need to find out that magic number which I told earlier. If I have 5 H index mani, so 5 means 5 ya 5 se jyada, at least 5 research papers aise hone chahiye jo ki 5 ya 5 se jyada bar sake. Let us understand this case mein kitne hain. Let me work with a random number say H index of say 5 over here. Let me check whether actually this case has got H index of 5 or not. If I assume it to be 5, this paper qualifies for the same because it has been cited more than 5 number of times. It has been cited 7 times, so it has been cited more number of times. This paper qualifies, where I have put a tick. This paper qualifies because it has been cited 5 number of times. This paper doesn't qualify because it has been cited lesser than 5 number of times. This paper qualifies, and this paper also qualifies. This paper doesn't qualify. So incidentally, although it was not prepared, I had just written some random numbers only. Incidentally, in this particular case, H index stands to be 5 on. So there are 5 research papers. See the papers which I am circling. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So there are 5 research papers which have been cited 5 or more number of times. So in this case, H index is 5. Let me take another example. So what I do, so I write again the count of research papers to be up to 8. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and let me write it up to 9. So this research paper is say, cited in 6, 5, 4, 3, and incidentally, author was very good in this particular research paper and which has been cited say 50 number of times. So 2, 7, 10, 8 and say this has not been cited at all. Can we find out what is the H index in this particular case? And again work with a random number, say 5 only. So I am assuming, it's just an assumption, that the H index is 5 here in this case as well. So this paper qualifies because it has been indexed more than 500 times. This paper qualifies. This paper doesn't qualify because it has been cited less than 500 times. This paper doesn't qualify. This paper qualifies. This paper doesn't qualify. This paper qualifies and this paper also qualifies. So incidentally, again, this is not planned. In this particular case as well, H index stands to be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So H index here as well is 5. So the purpose of taking this particular example was, although the citation for one particular research paper is 50, but that doesn't mean that the H index will also increase to that order. So it will still remain 5 only. Let me take another example. Let me take an example of only 2 research papers. So there is a researcher XYZ or any one of you, say, who has got only 2 research papers and whose citations are 50 and 100. So can you guess what will the H index in this particular case? Most of the time when the same question is asked in the classes to students or when I do take a seminar of faculty members, somebody will say the H index will be 50, somebody will say the H index will be 100. That is wrong. This particular researcher has authored only 2 research papers and both the research papers have been cited 2 or more number of times. So H index in this particular case is not 50, not 100, but it is 2. So what does it mean? Even if your research papers have been cited many number of times, 50 or 100 respectively, but the H index is still 2 on. I'm sure after these 3 examples, this particular concept will be clear that what is H index and how does it vary. Now let us talk about some of more information about H index. See, I always say that the world's biggest journal, that is Nature. And this information is very much available on this particular website, and everybody should refer to this website for finding out the H index of journal or even country as well. That is www.scimagojr.com. So the world's biggest journal is Nature, whose H index as per this website is 1096. So means 1096 articles are such which have been published in journal Nature, and each of these articles has been cited minimum 1096 or more number of times. So what does it mean? So now to garner or to earn this kind of H index, this journal has to be very very old journal. And you would be delighted to note that this journal was started in 1869, almost 150 years back. And this year is very very crucial or very important for Indian history, because for the same very year our father of the nation was also born. So Mahatma Gandhi ji was born the same year. So if Mahatma Gandhi would have been alive at this time, he would also have been 150 years old. The purpose of making this particular point here is, you can make out that the H index increases with the age of the entity. In this particular case, entity here is journal, name of the journal is Nature, and because this journal is as old as 150 years old, so H index has increased to 1096. So what does it mean? That if there is a new journal, so which started its operations only a couple of years back, so only 3 or 4 years back, so although the journal might be good, but because its age has not been that old, and so its H index might be relatively less. So I know a couple of journals which might be having H index of only say 4 or 5 only, but still the impact factor of those journals may be higher. Impact factor may be higher, but H index may be lower. May be lower for relatively new journals. Which means, before we choose a journal that where do we want to publish our article, we should not be solely dependent upon the count of H index, because H index of 10 or 15 seems to be very less, but it might be a new journal. So we should have an idea about both impact factor as well as H index also, right? So in this video we are focused only on H index. So in the next video, sometime later, so we'll be focusing upon impact factor as well, and what is the difference between H index and impact factor. Thank you very much.